Whether you're starting from scratch or you've been struggling to build momentum, there's no better time to start a YouTube channel than right now. The path to finding success on this platform can be challenging, frustrating, and outright maddening.
Shit.
But the world is waiting to hear your story, and it's time to figure out the steps to make it happen. This is Master YouTube. Hi there, and welcome to Master YouTube, and if this is your first course, welcome to the Slow Growth community. I like to think that this isn't just any course platform, and that's because really everything that comes out of this academy is underpinned by the slow growth philosophy. To me, slow growth is the belief that real sustainable progress is a marathon, not a sprint. And I know firsthand that's exactly what it takes to build your very own YouTube channel. I couldn't be more excited to be on this journey with you. My name is Matt Diavella. I'm a YouTuber and documentary filmmaker. And in this course, I'm gonna give you the roadmap for how to build a successful YouTube channel with integrity. Now, don't get me wrong, this is no easy feat and we've got so much ground to cover. But before we get into the lessons, I wanted to give you just a little bit of background about myself, my career as a filmmaker, and how the hell, out of all things, I came to teach a course on YouTube. Well, before I got started on YouTube, I was a freelance filmmaker. I shot weddings, bar mitzvahs, and local television commercials.
What are you doing?
Basically, if someone was willing to pay me for a video, I was happy to work for them. And yes, this B-roll that you're watching right now is from a 65th birthday party I filmed. If I'm being honest, those early years were a struggle, but it taught me so much about how to run a business, how to adapt my approach with new feedback, why clear communication is so vital, and it's where I developed my skills as a filmmaker and storyteller. For over 5 years, I inched my way up from filming birthday parties to working on creatively fulfilling projects with clients that I loved. Freelance filmmaking put me on my first flight at 18 years old. It took me all over the country and had me shooting with some iconic companies like Airbnb, Reebok, and Uber. I was so fortunate to be making videos for a living, but there was still something deep inside of me calling me to push things further. And so I decided that I would take the biggest leap and greatest risk of my career. I dropped everything and hit the road, investing $10,000 of my own money into my first feature-length documentary.
Awesome, nice to meet you. This is Matt.
Hi, Matt. How are you?
He has a big camera with me.
It's not that big.
What can I say? I've never been one to brag about the size of my camera. I seriously had no expectation of it doing well. If it was seen by a few thousand people and I made my money back, I'd be more than happy. It was just one of those things that I couldn't not do. And I poured everything I had into this project. I worked from 7 a.m. to 9 p.m. eating nothing but peanut butter sandwiches and drinking black coffee. Not a diet I'd recommend, by the way, but I felt like I was working on a project that was bigger than myself, and it deserved everything I had. As we drained more time and money into this project, and I lost my last bit of sanity with it, we finished the film just before our deadline. And while I would have been happy with a participation award at a local film festival, something unexpected happened. The film went to number one on iTunes, it trended on Netflix, and tens of millions of people all over the world watched it. It was mind-blowing and opened up my eyes to the possibility of what one person could create with a laptop in their bedroom. This was a huge moment for me as a filmmaker, and it completely changed my life. And one of the ways that it changed my life was that it gave me the confidence to take a step back and ask one really big question. If I could do anything with my life, regardless of money, what would it be? I decided that I still wanted to make videos, but I wanted to do it on my own terms. Instead of answering to clients or relying on someone else to give me permission, I wanted to build an audience for myself. And I had no idea where to start. You see, even though I had a successful documentary, I only had a couple hundred people following me online. And even that was made up almost entirely of my large Italian family. I knew that if I wanted to make the kind of films that I cared about, the stories that I was passionate about telling, then I would need to become self-reliant as an online creator. And so that's when I started my YouTube channel. Hey guys, what's going on? My name is Matt Diavella. I'm a documentary filmmaker, and this is my new YouTube channel. I'm pretty sure that in the very beginning, this is gonna be one of the worst things that anybody's ever heard, but it's gonna get really good. It's gonna get better. Those first few months were exciting, but I also faced resistance. Self-doubt was always lurking in the background, telling me that I'd never be good enough, that this wasn't gonna work out, that I was a fool for even trying. Pushing doubt to the side, I kept going. Even though no one was watching, I was just having too much fun to stop.
I'm not sure where to look, I'm not sure what to do with my hands.
And so I continued to show up every day to make the best possible videos I could. Some of the videos I made sucked, and some were pretty good.
I used those early days to experiment as a storyteller. I used whatever resources I could find to get the job done, and I didn't let excuses get in my way.
Oh my God, these shots, this has been a whole day thing.
And then I started to see some breakthroughs.
So we're looking at, I went from about 120 to 130 YouTube subscribers to today, literally overnight, I have 475.
A few hundred subscribers turned into a couple thousand.
I got 50,000 subscribers here on YouTube.
I met hundreds of other creators who inspired me and taught me so many different paths that you can take to find success on YouTube. Over the course of a couple years, I eventually grew an audience for myself, getting over 3 million subscribers and creating a sustainable income on YouTube.
If there's any lesson, there's always gotta be a lesson in one of Matt's videos. The lesson would be, just keep trying to do better. Thanks for watching. See you next time.
But the best part, I wasn't just making videos that scratched a creative itch. I was making videos that filled my soul and gave me a sense of purpose.
Honestly, I hope to look back someday and say that's hilarious that I got excited over 300, 400 subscribers. But it's a huge bump for me. I'm really excited about it, and I'm excited to see where this could go.
And this road has brought me right here to teach you everything that I've learned over the past few years about how to build a YouTube channel that you're proud of. I want to show you how to create meaningful content. I want to help you express your voice and share your story. And I want to help you connect with other inspiring creatives to take that leap towards the creative career that you've always dreamed of. So what do you say? Let's get to work.
If you want to get an even greater understanding of the steps I took to make my first feature-length documentary, Minimalism, I have a free 6-part series available on YouTube. It's called Making Minimalism. You'll be able to find the link to that series in the resources below this lesson. This series, by the way, was one of my first big projects on YouTube that helped me to get my first few thousand subscribers. I'll talk more about it later on in the course. I also have a video on YouTube that I made recently detailing how I got both of my films onto Netflix. That video is in the resources as well.